Hi viewers, welcome to LMI Solution. Today we are going to see about modeling and simulation of proton exchange membrane fuel cells. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. So first we have to see the some reference paper. So I have used this paper for simulating that modeling and model and simulate the proton exchange membrane fuel cell. So here you can see the different detail, right? Now to model that proton exchange membrane fuel cell. So here you can see that, so this is a fuel cell voltage VFC, which is equal to V in earnest minus V activation and minus V ohmic minus V concentration. So this is a fuel cell voltage equation. And then suppose n cells connected in series and final fuel cell stack voltage, which is equal to Vs equal to n into VFC. So here you can see that nothing but thermodynamic potential of each unit cell in the fuel cell, and then V act nothing but a voltage drop associated with the activation of anode and of the cathode, and V ohmic nothing but ohmic voltage drop. So this is nothing but measure of voltage drop associated with the conduction of proton electrons, and finally next we have concentration voltage. So represents the voltage drop resulting from the decrease in concentration of oxygen and hydrogen. Okay, so this is the detailed about the two different voltage in the fuel cell. So each have some equation, right? So first we can see that in earnest, right? So this equation for in earnest thermodynamics of that thermodynamic potential of the fuel cell. Okay, so it consists of that means it depends upon temperature, fuel cell temperature, and pressure of the hydrogen and pressure of the oxygen, right? And next we can see that activation voltage. So it depends upon different parameter. That parameter nothing but zeta 1, 2, 3, temperature, and then IFC. Okay. The zeta 1, zeta 2 nothing but parameter coefficient. So that can be taken from the data taken from the real-time fuel cell. Okay. So next, ohmic potential, which is equal to IFC into RM to RC. So RC nothing but contact resistance, RM nothing but membrane resistance. Okay. So it depends upon the following parameter. That means rho M into L divided by A. L nothing but thickness, and A nothing but cell active area. Okay. And next, finally, we have concentration voltage, so which is equal to minus B into ln 1 minus J B J max. Okay. So J nothing but current density, and then J max nothing maximum current density of the fuel cell. Okay. So B nothing but a constant, is depends on the cell type. Okay. So next you have to see the CO2 equation, right? CO2 can be calculated by means of this equation. So same way we can calculate RM, that means RM equal to rho M divided by L by A. So RM, that means rho M nothing but membrane specific resistivity. So that can be calculated by means of this equation. Okay. So these are the equation used for modeling that fuel cell. The same equation can be used for simulating that summing the fuel cell in the MATLAB simulation. So here we can check the results, different results. That means we can check the graph between stack voltage and stack current, and also we can check the response of the system by varying the zeta one, right? So we can check this result, and then we can check the result of this fuel cell with varying zeta 3. Okay, So we are going to see the following details in the simulation. So now I'm going to open the MATLAB. Also, I'm going to open the fuel cell detail. Already we implemented the equation. So here you can see the detail, right? So this detail is taken from that paper, right? That means here, so you can see here, right? Yeah, this one. So they provided that fuel cell, 500 watts fuel cell detail, right? Number of cell, active area, thickness, temperature, pressure of oxygen, pressure of hydrogen, contact resistance, and then constant based upon cell type, zeta 1, 2, 3, and 4, and psi, j n, j max, and then c. Okay, so same detail we are going to use the simulation also here, right? So these are the detail is taken from the paper. So here that equation, right? That fuel cell equation here depends upon IFC, right? So here IFC is taken as the input. So now to get that graph between stack voltage and current. Okay, so I'm going to create that for loop. So they have taken as 500 watts, right? And then the maximum current that can drawn, that when drawn from the fuel cell, is around 29.8 amps. So I'm going to vary the IFC from 0 to 29.8 with the 0.1 amps increment. Okay, so every IFC current I'm going to calculate earnest voltage, CO2, Z2. So Z2, so can be that means this equation is taken from the paper. Okay, here, right? The same equation used for calculating that Z2, and then activation voltage, and then rho m, and then rm, and then ohmic voltage, and then concentration voltage. So finally we have to combine that different equation to find out the fuel cell voltage and then current. So finally you have to that when draw the graph between fuel cell current and the fuel cell voltage. So I'm going to simulate this model. So here you can see that this is the result of that consider a fuel cell stack. So graph between fuel cell voltage and current. Just you have to compare with the result of that paper. So here you can see that. So this is a result, simulation result that meant that this line, right, block line, right? So result of simulation. So same kind of result we are getting. Okay. So next we need to test the same model with different settings of zeta 1, right? So minus 0.85, minus 948, minus 1.043. So for that we created the same thing, right? Here we are fixing that parameter coefficient for z1 minus 0.853, minus 0.948, minus 1.043. So you have to pass this value and then we have to draw the graph for that fuel cell. So I'm going to simulate this model. Yeah, you will get this result, right? So we can check the same result, that means result with that paper, right? Here you can see that. So we are getting same kind of graph when compared to the paper results, right? So when we change that parameter Z down, right, the graph will be shifted downwards, right? When you got to increase that decrease that zeta 1 from minus 0.853 to minus 0.948, the graph is shifted downwards, right? When the zeta value is decrease from minus 0.948 to minus 1.043, so one sign that graph is shifted to below that previous one, right? So next you have to vary that zeta 3, right? For different value of zeta 3, you have to check the response of the fuel cell. So next, I'm going to open this model. So here we taken three value for that zeta 3. So the each value when we passes through the program, and then you have to plot the graph between fuel cell voltage and current. Okay. First, I'm going to simulate this model. So now you can see that. So this is a graph for that fuel cell voltage and current for different settings of zeta 3. Right. Here I'm going to compare that result with the paper results, right? So here also you can see that we are getting similar kind of result. That mean that and the graph is shifted downwards because of increasing that zeta 3. Okay. So this video explained about that modeling and simulation of the proton exchange membrane fuel cell. Okay. Thank you for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much.